Hey everyone, welcome back to NDC. And if you're a developer, you've probably heard the buzz about AI coding assistants. And today we're diving into one of the most talked about ones, GitHub Copilot. Now, I'll be honest with you, I haven't used GitHub Copilot much, and I've still been playing around with the new AI features of Xcode Beta 26. My goal for this video is to show you how to effectively use Copilot in Visual Studio Code to speed up your coding, reduce repetitive tasks, and maybe help you learn new things along the way. Whether you're building a new Python script, a backend, or just exploring new ideas, Copilot can be a real game changer. So what is GitHub Copilot? Well, you can use it directly on github.com, or you can integrate it with Visual Studio Code. It's an AI tool developed by GitHub and OpenAI. Instead of just auto-completing individual words, Copilot understands the context of your code, what you're trying to do, variable names that you're using, even the comments that you write. It then takes that understanding to suggest entire lines of code, functions, or even full files in real time. It's trained on massive amount of publicly available code, allowing it to generate suggestions in many different programming languages. So before we can unleash the coding magic, we need to get it set up in Visual Studio Code. Some prerequisites: you need to have a GitHub account, of course, and you'll need to have that GitHub account synced to Visual Studio Code. Once you've done that, you can head on over to the Extensions tab on Visual Studio Code, and it'll probably be the first one that's recommended. Otherwise, we can search for GitHub Copilot here. Let's go ahead and install it. Give it the permissions that it needs. You can even choose to enable or disable the chat panel. As you can see, we have like a little chat in the right side, just like if you've used ChatGPT or DeepSeek before. As a reminder, you're always in control, and it's something that's powered by your creativity. So once we're all set up, you may also get prompted to go to the website and sign in or enable the Copilot there. For the most part, you should be able to do everything you need to within the Visual Studio Code window. So even if we close out of this window and we create a new file, I'm just going to do a Python one today. We can see at the very top, we now have the option to have the key bindings. I'm on Mac, so mine's Command I, to ask GitHub Copilot to do something, or we can start typing to dismiss. You'll also notice that we have this little GitHub button at the very top, and we can even click on it to open up the chat if we'd like, but we're going to be using the more kind of inline tools today. Let's say I want to create a Python project, and in this one I'm going to have a function that just adds two numbers, and that'll be represented by A and B. So see this faint gray text here? Apologies if it's a little hard to read. This is actually Copilot's suggestion. I can press tab to then accept it and inject it into my code directly. How cool is that? Let's try something a little bit differently. Let's say I want to create an array of names. Maybe I'll have like, we can even use the autofill here for the names. And say I want to iterate through those names. So maybe I do for I, name in, we'll enumerate the names here. And we can see that's giving me some options. If I move my mouse cursor to where we're currently situated, we can see that we have some suggestions here. And you might have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different suggestions. And you can actually look through those different suggestions by pressing on the key here, or you can use the hotkey on your keyboard. If you're using Windows, it would be Alt and the bracket. For Mac, it's the Option and then those brackets. And you can tab through these different suggestions that it may have. You'll also notice that we can see that there's an expected indent block and we have a problem. Maybe we can use a quick fix to either fix it with Copilot or get an explanation. For me, it's just the tab indentation was a little bit wrong. We can accept those changes as well. Copilot isn't just good for single lines. It can generate entire chunks of boilerplate code, saving you a ton of time and looking up syntax. So let's say I wanted to create a basic web Flask application. Instead of looking everything up and doing all the imports and initialization, I can just tell Copilot what I want. You can feel free to use the chat, but I want to show you that comments actually work too. I'm going to add my hashtag and then I'll say create a simple Flask web application. Cool, I'm going to hit return on my keyboard and we can see that it's actually suggesting the imports. So I'm going to hit tab. I'm going to hit return again. We're adding the Flask name. We're establishing the app route, right? And as I hit return and tab, it's going to be doing a lot of this coding for me. We can even add the function to submit. And you can even see down here, we found a reference to public code in a recent suggestion. And you can even view that reference if you'd like. But we can kind of just go through and we can write all of this boilerplate code. And we can add our app.run debug true, and we're pretty much good to go. You can actually keep going, so if the index is HTML, but this is pretty good for a boilerplate code for a Flask app. This is incredibly powerful for kickstarting projects or adding common components really quickly. So this is one of my favorite features where Copilot really feels like magic. You can describe what you want in plain English, and Copilot will try to write code for you. It's like having a coding translator. So let's try a really classic example, calculating the Fibonacci sequence, if I can remember how to spell that. But let's add our comment again. I want a function to calculate the, we'll use the nth here, Fibonacci number. Oh, it even has the spelling for me here. Haha, I have to embarrass myself. Let's do it recursively. And as I type out the function signature, Copilot should actually fill in the body. So we'll call this one the Fibonacci. Gonna apply n. And we can see here, it knows exactly what to do. So it gets the logic just from my comment and function signature. Beyond generating code, Copilot can also help you understand and improve existing code. This is where Copilot Chat and Visual Studio Code becomes really handy. I know on my Windows PC, it's actually on the left side, but for some reason on my Mac, it's up here, totally fine. You can ask Copilot and use the chat. So let's take a look at the Fibonacci sequence we just made. You can highlight it. Then in the Copilot chat, we can actually use the slash explain. We'll send it a message and it'll actually give us the explanation of the code. I'll expand it so it's a little bit easier to read for us here. This is fantastic for understanding code that you didn't write or reminding yourself of what a complex function does. We can even ask it for optimization. So you can even see this suggestion here. How can we optimize this function? We even have the optimized version being suggested using memoization. There's also an iterative approach as well. All of these have different explanations. And if we really wanted to, we can copy the code with the copy button here. We can also insert it at the cursor or apply it in the editor directly. And it's going to apply the code block inside of our editor. And if we even wanted to, we can use this to write and generate tests. We can use the slash test command and we can give it some information, but for this one, it should know. But let's go ahead and say generate unit test for this code. Go ahead and send it off. It's actually going to create a new file for us called the test_Fibonacci.py. It's going to use Python's unit test, and it's going to test the different functionality. Go ahead and apply those edits, and you can see that it's actually added the code into our workspace. This is a great starting point for ensuring your code works as expected, and it saves you the initial setup and time to write those tests. Another really cool part about Copilot is it doesn't just look at the code file that you're using. It actually grabs context from your entire workspace. So it will look at the file you're currently editing, other files in your workspace, so those folders, the function or class that you're inside, any variable names, function signatures, and comments that are also available. This is also why writing clean code, clear variable names, well-defined function signatures, and descriptive comments are so important. The more context that you actually give Copilot, the more accurate and helpful its suggestions will be. I'm always telling people, write comments, 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 and that's still remaining true. If you do want to change the settings of Copilot in Visual Studio Code, if you're in Windows, you can do Control plus the comma. If you're on Mac, Command comma, and this will bring up settings for Visual Studio Code. Just gonna close our chat here. You can either search for Copilot, or they should be in the extensions over here. We'll just go ahead and do Copilot. We can go to our GitHub Copilot. You can see the ability to enable or disable it to have it show those inline completions if you really don't like it. There's so many different features that you can enable or disable and really make it your own. I'd recommend experimenting with these, especially if you're someone who doesn't really like it aggressively suggesting the code. Totally up to you how you want to augment and change these things. You can even choose which language it shows you in. So by default, my device is on English, but if you want Copilot in a certain language, feel free to do so. If you don't want it to rename, if you, you know, don't want the instructions, right? There's lots that you can do. You can even choose to allow it to edit or not edit. So play around with these. Again, you might want it not to be that aggressive. I find I don't want it on every single line of code. I like to personally ask it for help and for those suggestions rather than it just being like always in my face. Now, lastly, I just want to leave off with some words of advice. Copilot is a fantastic assistant, but it's not a magic bullet. Get the most out of it. Here's some best practices. Treat it more of as an assistant, not as a replacement. Copilot can write code, but you're the developer. You're still in charge of logic and quality. Think of it as like having a junior dev right next to you. You wouldn't just blindly accept everything that they would type for us. Check it for the logic and the quality. Always review and try to understand the generated code. Don't just spam tab and move on. You know, check, does it make sense? Is it efficient? Does it have a subtle bug? Taking it piece by piece as you go is going to help you avoid issues as you go. Iterative prompting is also something that's very important. So if Copilot's first suggestion isn't quite right, try to be a little bit more specific, right? So if I were to just go to our chat and I'd say, hey, fix this, right? It really wouldn't know what to do. But if I really wanted to, or if I added some prompts before and it didn't really work, be very specific. So maybe I wasn't happy with this optimized Fibonacci function using iteration. Maybe I'd say add print statements along the way to help debug and track each cycle, right? And we can go ahead and send that off. It's going to generate, right? So make sure that if your prompt doesn't work the first time, identify what's not happening. Prompting is something that also just takes time, and the more that you do it, the more comfortable you may become with this. And now we've added this like extra logging as we're going here. Now create the game snake for me. Let's try out this snake game. I'm actually curious how it did here. And save this as snake game. We can run this. Oh, I don't have Pygame installed on this machine. Hold on. I'm just curious now. All right, this is our snake game. You know what? This one worked out pretty well. Woohoo! Lots to improve upon. I'm doing so good. Okay. Oh, can we eat ourselves? Yeah, we can eat ourselves and get a trigger game over. You know what? Not too terrible. And while powerful, as we can see with this snake example, we also have to remember that, oh my gosh, I can't grab this one. Well, I'm not perfect either. Copilot is not perfect. Yeah, remember, it predicts based on patterns, and sometimes those patterns lead to suboptimal or even buggy code. Always, always, always test what it generates. Also make sure you're not pasting any sensitive data, API keys, passwords, or confidential client information in your editor, hoping Copilot will understand it. Copilot's models are actually remote, and you should treat sensitive data in general always accordingly. Also, there's a risk of becoming too reliant on Copilot and not truly understanding the code that you're writing. Use it to augment your skills, not replace them. If you don't understand a suggestion, take the time to learn why it's there. So there you have it, a beginner's guide to effectively using GitHub Copilot and Visual Studio Code. As you can see, even as someone who doesn't use it much, the power is undeniable. It's an incredible tool for boosting your productivity, reducing repetitive code, and even helping you learn new syntax patterns. And my biggest takeaway for you would be experiment. The more you use Copilot and provide it with good context, the better it becomes at assisting you. I also want to note, I'm just using the free version of Copilot as I don't use it often. I believe just like with a lot of the LLMs, you have a limited amount of uses per month. And if you want more uses, I believe you can pay for it. But if you are a student in education, you might be able to actually access Copilot for free through your organizations. So you might want to check that out as well. If this video helped you get started with GitHub Copilot, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more practical developer tips. I do some videos on Python, iOS development, SwiftUI. So hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. And let me know in the comments below, have you used Copilot? What's your favorite feature? Or are there any challenges that you've been facing? I'd love to hear from you. So dream big, code bigger, and we'll see you in the next one.